Today on Upfront, a close call for a Wisconsin company and hundreds of its workers. Why did a little-known bank nearly scuttle an order worth $600 million? The president of Bucyrus International talks about the deal that almost wasn't, and if this is a sign of things to come.
Then, this is the last weekend smokers can light up in restaurants and taverns. Wisconsin goes smoke-free Monday. The executive director of the Tavern League says this will destroy some businesses. Who could be closing down? And how soon he says it will happen? It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gousha.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. We begin today with a story of lessons learned, the story of Bucyrus International. Bucyrus is the South Milwaukee company whose experience with a federal agency most people had never heard of until last week triggered a political firestorm. For a while, it appeared the jobs of 1,000 workers, 300 of them in Wisconsin, were in jeopardy. Today, it appears those jobs are safe, but what happened to Bucyrus raises some interesting questions about priorities and politics. We'll get to those in just a moment. But first, the backstory. Bucyrus makes mining equipment, and up until about a week ago, it thought it had a $600 million deal with a company that was building a coal-fired power plant and mine in India. Then suddenly, the U.S. Export-Import Bank canceled its loan guarantees to the Indian company. It cited environmental concerns and the Obama administration's desire to move away from fossil fuel projects. The deal was off. With 1,000 jobs now in jeopardy, Bucyrus, its workers, and lawmakers from both parties called on the Obama administration to pressure the bank to reverse its decision. And early Wednesday morning, just hours before the president visited Racine, it did just that. After verbally pledging to invest in renewable energy projects in the future, the Indian company was told it will get its loan. Bucyrus will apparently get its $600 million order. The jobs will be saved. At least that's the way it appears today. Joining us now is Bucyrus President and CEO Tim Sullivan. Mr. Sullivan, thanks very much for being with us.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Interesting week. I guess the question now is there anything that you foresee that could prevent this deal from happening?
I think because the national furor over this whole issue, hopefully no, but it's not over yet. I mean, we still have to get a vote from the board of the Exim Bank approving this loan. And that's not certain. I mean, you know, we have some time yet before that's going to happen. We were hoping a vote could have happened Thursday of this past week, but now it could be scheduled for Thursday of this upcoming week.
The Indian company says, though, that they do want to do business with you. They say they'll wait that long until this is all approved?
They've been incredibly patient. You know, this application should go through in a couple of months. It's been 8 months. They're hanging with us. I mean, they're great guys, and they're going to try to hang with us as long as they can, but the Exim Bank has to move this along quickly now.
In business and in life, you learn from your experiences. What lessons have you learned from this particular experience?
Never expect what you expect, I guess, is maybe the answer. This should have been the easiest decision the Exim Bank could have taken. This project met all the guidelines. It was clear that it should have been approved. It was the very best power plant that's made today. It's a supercritical power plant with the lowest carbon emissions in the world. An easy decision for the Exim Bank. So when this one took a left-hand turn, shocking. I mean, it was just amazing to anyone that knew of this process.
So with a couple of days to reflect on this, what do you think happened? What really happened here?
Well, I think it became political. I really do. I think that for whatever reason, the two members of the Exim Bank board took this thing to a different level, a very subjective level, saying, you know, it's not renewable, we can't approve it, completely out of bounds. I mean, completely beyond their charter, which would create the firestorm. This is not what they're about.
The question that I guess arises from this, is this a sign of things to come for your industry, for your workers, for people who are in the same business you are? As the country appears to be moving away from fossil fuel and toward renewable energy projects, should you be concerned about the future of your company and others like it?
Now, that question's come up, obviously, over the last couple of days. What's interesting, 77 countries have coal reserves in the world. The BRIC countries, you know, Brazil, Russia, India, China, massive coal reserves. They're going to burn coal. It's inexpensive, and they have it in great quantities. We're barking down the wrong path here. What we have to do is work with these countries to make sure they burn that coal clean. These people did all the right things. They went out and bought a supercritical power plant. They had the lowest carbon emissions of any power plant in the world. They're doing the right things, and yet we said, it's just not good enough. That's the wrong answer to project to the developing world.
Scott Walker, who is a Republican candidate for governor of the Milwaukee County Executive, said he called this radical environmental policies on the part of the Obama administration that were threatening to kill Bucyrus jobs. Do you agree with that assessment?
That's a strong comment, but I guess in many respects it's factual. If you're only going to invest in renewable energy, that's wrong. I mean, that will kill not only jobs here in the United States, it's going to kill a lot of jobs in our industry. It's going to happen. I mean, coal is the most abundant, most bountiful resource that's out there. We have to deal with that. And to concentrate clearly on renewables only, yeah, it's a pretty radical decision.
You're saying that the administration should be pressuring these companies to do cleaner coal, that they shouldn't just abandon coal because somebody will finance these projects. Someone will get this work. Is that what you're saying?
That's exactly it. Absolutely, that's it. 52% of our power in the United States comes from coal. Almost 100% of the power that's going to come in India, China, and Russia over the next coming years is going to be predominantly coal generated. You got to deal with that. You can't cast a blind eye towards that.
If you're concerned about the politics of the Export-Import Bank, what do you do about it? You're going to go to Washington, you said?
Yeah, I'm heading to Washington. Chairman Hochberg, myself, Senator Cole has agreed to get involved. We have John Engler, former governor of Michigan, who's the CEO now of the National Association of Manufacturing, is going to help participate in this. We got to get this back on track. I told Chairman Hochberg, we cannot continue to go down this path where we're trying to broker politics against common sense for business and exporters. It's jobs, it's exports, it's balance of trade, it's doing the right thing for our country, so we got to get this back on track.
Do you think the Obama administration deserves any credit for getting this project back on track, or does it deserve blame for sending mixed signals about its priorities?
Well, there were mixed signals, obviously. I mean, Chairman Hochberg, made the comment on Thursday night that he was just trying to follow administration policies on carbon. That's an administrative situation. So, I'm happy that the administration got involved very quickly and tried to right this wrong as quickly as they could. Obviously, there was some impetus behind that with the president coming here on Wednesday. Obviously, that was good for us. A fortuitous visit by the president helped expedite that. But, you got to separate the politics from business on this one.
Do you think this decision would have been reversed had the president not been scheduled to visit Racine on Wednesday?
Not in the time frame that it did.
And to you, the time frame would have been crucial.
It's critical.
A matter of days might have meant they've moved on.
Well, we got letters of cancellation from our customer on Monday. And I still have those letters on my desk. And they basically said, your window is short. Thanks. I'm glad that they're going to reconsider this. But they better decide quickly because we've got to move on. They've got a power plant under construction that basically has to start producing power in the first quarter of 2012. That sounds like a long period of time. That's not long for the type of lead times that it takes us to build our equipment.
You have other projects that you'd like to move forward on. How many of them and what is their status now given what has occurred in the last week or so?
Well, there's four known projects today. One from South Africa is actually in the Exim Bank for consideration right now. I'm very worried about that one. We've held back three others, talking to our customers, saying, hold those applications back, one from Turkey, two from India. This was the best of the best. So, we have to get our whole priority set before these projects come in, or that means more jobs are going to be lost.
Final question, and I just want to get your assessment. You're a leading manufacturer in the state. I want to get your assessment of the economy. We had some numbers come out again on Friday, and people do have some concerns about how the economy is doing at this point and whether it's moving forward at the pace we'd all like to see it move forward at. How do you assess how we're doing right now?
It is moving forward. It's improving. I track basically power consumption. What's interesting is power consumption is slowly but surely moving up in the country. That's a leading indicator of the fact that the economy is coming back. It's slow. You're talking to all the people that I talk to around southeastern Wisconsin, some of my counterparts in different industries. It's coming back, but it's painstakingly slow. We're really not looking to get back to anything at a reasonable economic growth level until maybe this time next year, even the end of 2011. So frustrating, but it is moving in the right direction.
All right. Tim Sullivan, the president and the CEO of Bucyrus International. Thanks very much for being with us today. We do appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me on, Mike.
The smoke will clear in Wisconsin Monday. The state goes smoke-free. Next, I'll talk to the executive director of the Wisconsin Tavern League about what he says will happen to taverns and restaurants within days.
Then the case that has the state Supreme Court divided, when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Gousha, brought to you by American Transmission Company. We'll be right back.